Steve Dotto, how the heck are you this fine day? Me? I've come to a stark realization, and I recognize that for the past several months, we have been concentrating on all sorts of individual apps here on Dotto Tech. We've been talking about Asana, we've been talking about Todoist, we've been talking about Trello, we've been talking about Gmail, we've been talking about Evernote, of course. We've been talking about all of these apps as kind of silos. But you know, no app is an island. They work together really well, and we need them to work together in order to really do our job. So today, I thought we would take a lesson from the apps, a lesson that our society could learn a lot from, how to work together better. Yes, no app is an island today on Dotto Tech. I can't believe this. That I'm actually saying this, but in some ways I pined for the old days of just having Outlook as my only contact and task and calendar manager. It was life was simpler back in the Outlook days. It was probably even simpler in the paper days, but I always had terrible handwriting. So Outlook for me was probably the epitome of me being in control of everything in my life. But of course, it's tremendously limiting and it frankly sucks in so many ways. So today we are so much farther ahead with the apps that we have access to and how they all work. But really, for us to make them work for us, they each have to talk to each other. Because, you know, our task manager has to know what's going on as far as our calendar is concerned. Our calendar has to know what's going on as far as our Evernote is concerned. And our email is the busybody that has to know what's happening in everybody's life. So we need all of these different apps to connect and to work together. So, and we've been talking a lot in the last couple of months about individual apps and celebrating individual apps. So today I thought we would celebrate the connections between those apps. A little bit of a narrative taking us on a journey of how one app connects to another app connects to another app to give you an idea of how you might layer in your apps. Now, I don't care which email you use and which apps you use. If you look for the capabilities that I'm going to be talking about today in this demo, you will be able to build your own system where one is going to talk to the other and make you that much more efficient. So let's dive in. And most of our responsibilities begin and end with email, don't they? That's where things kind of start. So I'm just going to take you on a bit of a tour of the way, one of the ways that I set things up in my life. So here I've got a bill. I've got a bill from my buddies at Rogers in Canada. They are our mobility carrier, and that bill has to be paid. It's got to be paid. So I could pay it right now, but I'm going to do all of my banking stuff a little bit later. So I actually want to save this bill in several different places. I don't want it to just live in email. I want to file it away. So I want to send it to Evernote so that I've got it there when I need it, when I need to look it up. And I also want to make it a task because it's something that I want to do kind of as an appointment a little bit later in the day. I want to do that as a task on my task list to do. So here's what typically I do, or one way that you can do this, tying in a couple of my different tools. So I am using increasingly a task manager called Todoist. We've got some demos on it. It's an awesome product. I like how simple it is, but I also love its integration, how it integrates with so many other tools. So in one of the tools that it integrates brilliantly with through a Chrome add-in here or a browser add-in is Gmail. So you see how I've got my bill up here. I can just add whatever's in this email to Todoist. I click on this button and it takes the title. I can change the name of it, but your Rogers bill is available seems to be a pretty good name. And then I can send it directly into Todoist. And I can actually select which of my projects I'm going to send it into, but I'm just going to have it go into my inbox right now. And I'm just going to save that as a task for me to do. So I could have added a few extra details to it at that point there, but it's good enough now. It's sent in. Now I can go on to the next part of my day. I know that later on today, I will take care of paying that bill when I do all my banking. Next, I want to save this bill. So where I want to save this bill is to Evernote, where I save all of these bills. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this same bill and I'm going to forward it to my Evernote account because Evernote has an email address attached to it. I'm not even going to bother changing the name because I'll recognize the name again once it's in Evernote, and I'm sending it in to the Evernote inbox. So think about what I've just done with this email in a few seconds, is I've put it into my system. Now, it could be far more elaborate, the sorts of things that I wanted to do with it, but I've migrated it out of email, where it's not the best place to work with it, and I've put it into my archiving system, into Evernote, and I've put it into my into process by putting it into Todoist. Very simple, but because of the integration, because Evernote allows apps to, or allows us to email directly into it, and Todoist allows us to connect directly out of Gmail. And actually, if I didn't want to connect out of Gmail, I could actually send it to Todoist as an email as well. Almost all of these apps have email attached, but I've now moved it out of email into the place that it should be worked on. Pretty cool, eh? Let's take a look and see if it worked. Well, first of all, jump over into Todoist, and there's Todoist. And if I take a look in my tasks for today, your Rogers bill is now available. Woohoo! Ready to pay. So if I click on this task, I can bring it up and it will actually load the offending email for me. Brilliant. Works just perfectly. Let's head over into Evernote just for a second and make sure that it all worked there too. And I'm going to sync Evernote, make sure that everything is done properly here because it hasn't synced in a few seconds. Evernote syncs. I don't know how often it syncs. Probably every 3 or 4 minutes, but a forced sync here says, yes, there it is indeed. My Rogers bill is now available. So what I would do really now is I would take this bill and I will file it into my accounting section so that it's filed, so that I have it and I can retrieve it when I need. I won't do much more with it here in Evernote. So there we see one app talking to two other apps. No app is an island. Gmail spoke and took the bill and put it into Todoist, and it also archived it in Evernote. Pretty cool. Let's see about information going the other way, out of Evernote now, into some of those other things, because often I'm composing information in Evernote. Let's start a new note in Evernote, and I'm going to call it something impressive. Okay, now, often when you are making notes in Evernote, you're in a meeting and you have a reason that you need to, you have tasks that you're going to create. You're going to have action items that are going to come out of notes that you're creating. And it doesn't have to be in a meeting. You could be sitting down typing away, working on a project, and tasks will come up. And you might have to do something important. One and more important. Two. Okay, so the way that this works in the way that we can now automatically migrate the information out of Evernote into our task app is using some internal tagging structure that's built into Evernote. Now, I use a program called TaskClone, which creates a conduit between Evernote and other apps. Now, it'll do it to Todoist, but we've already shown you some stuff in Todoist. So instead, I want to show you this going to Asana, which is another popular task and to-do list app. So how you do it is, and it's actually quite a bit of brilliance. We have a video, if you want to watch a total demo on how you actually configure all of this, because I'm just going to show you the end game, not the actual configuration right now. But what you do is you add one of the checkboxes, which creates an automatic kind of to-do list within Evernote. But it just sits, it's just a static to-do list in Evernote until we add a tag. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a tag called to Asana. That tells Asana, or that tells Evernote, that this note is actually a to-do list which should be exported to our to-do list manager, whichever one we happen to have chosen. And it'll export to other things besides to-do list. It'll actually export to Google Calendar as well, should we choose, but I'm getting way ahead of myself. Right now, this will export to Todoist, in this case to Asana, as a task. And I'll sync that and we'll see kind of a report coming back to us in just a moment here. Boom. It's got a sync, and once it's synced, it'll come back and it'll tell us that, it'll give us a little TC telling us that Task Clone has taken this note and successfully synced it through to Asana. Did you see that? It just changed to say TC. That tells me that it's now synced it over to Asana. So let's jump over, and here is my Asana up and operating, and look. It's already imported. It happened that fast. So this was in real time. There's no bells and whistles here, folks. I didn't cut and edit this thing. I just basically, from the start of that Evernote segment to now, has been real time that you've seen in my recording time. And there are the tasks in Evernote. And here's the beauty. It tells me that they've come from Evernote. So now I can take these tasks and I can discharge them at and take care of them myself. This is in Asana. The exact same process could happen to Trello, to Todoist, to any task app that you have. Again, no app is an island. We see Evernote now talking out to our other apps. But Evernote will also talk to our calendar. Now, the calendar tool that I'm using right now, I'll just show it to you quickly right here, is called Sunrise Calendar. Now, Sunrise, we've got another demo on. Surprise, surprise. But the reason I like Sunrise is when we look in Sunrise right here and we go into the accounts, these are the things that Sunrise will connect to. So Sunrise connects to all of these different services. So you see, I have them. I have mine connected to my Google account, so my calendar, my Todoist account, my Evernote account, and my Asana account. So again, no app being an island, the reason that I like Sunrise so much is besides the fact that it works on every platform, on my Android phone, on my iOS phone, on my desktop computer, regardless of what operating system I'm in, works on all of those and gives me a nice calendar function with a little bit of limitation. It doesn't do a real good job of handling invites, but everything else does a pretty good job of. But here, because of the Evernote integration, and it's not super detailed and super deep, but let's take the same note and let's turn it into a reminder. And when I add a reminder to this note, I can set a date for the reminder to occur. So I'm just going to put it for this coming Sunday, and I'm going to ask it to save it for Sunday. And now what happens when this syncs? The same sort of process should happen that just happened with Asana, is Evernote should now talk to Sunrise Calendar, which should say, oh, I've got an appointment. I'm going to put that appointment in my calendar. So let's go over to Sunrise Calendar, back to Sunrise, and let's see. Let's let it refresh, and let's hope that it's done it properly. Here it is. So this is Sunday coming up. I'll go next week because it's this coming Sunday, not last Sunday. And hopefully right here, there it is, something impressive. And do you see how it has the little Evernote note attached to it? It's green and it tells me it's coming from Evernote. It tells me that it's come from Evernote. And if I want to go back and view this note in Evernote, even if I'm not on my home computer, if I'm on a different computer, it will launch Evernote in the web browser. And there is the note in the web browser available to me. So I can gain context. I can see all of the information. You know, this has just been a little cycle, showing you how one app can talk to another app and can help to save us time and energy. And I hope that you've kind of figured out from this demo just exactly what you can do with these different class of apps, with our calendar app, with our email app, with our task and to-do list app, and with Evernote, and how we can start to build our own system by combining them together and making sure that one talks to the other. And as you're evaluating and choosing which tool is best for you, this process that I've just gone through, looking at finding out exactly how they integrate, is very high on my list of things that I would always do. There, I'm done. I hope you found this to be useful. There's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. First, please subscribe to our channel. Secondly, is you can subscribe to our newsletter and you will hear about upcoming webinars and other special events. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. We are supported by our friends at Patreon, and if you drop by our Patreon site and take a look, essentially what happens with Patreon is you commit a small amount of money every month, which means I don't have to go out chasing advertising. I can produce more good content like this, and for that, you get perks. Amongst the perks include access to our courses, one of which would teach you all the stuff that I've just been talking about right now, as we have a new task app course that's available. At the $10 a month patronage level, you get access to those courses, as well as my Evernote course, which is just a killer course. So please, if you're interested, drop by Patreon. I hope that you found today's video to be useful. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.